welcome to CSIRO Pod. I'm Glenn Paul. When you think about air pollution and greenhouse gas emissions, you probably think of fossil-fueled electrical power plants and motor vehicles. And while they certainly are major contributors, there are other things out there also leaving their footprint.
Shipping is a major driver in the Australian economy, with over $200 billion worth of exports passing through Australian ports every year. But with these ships comes pollution. A CSIRO study has found that ship engine exhaust emissions make up more than a quarter of nitrogen oxide emissions generated in the Australian region.
And it turns out to be quite significant. For nitrogen oxides, about 30% of the total of emissions in the Australian region comes from shipping. These ships travel near the coasts and come into ports, and for many of our ports you have prevailing onshore winds, and so these pollutants are carried into the urban airsheds. They are mixed with the other pollutants and contribute to the total load of pollutants that our population is experiencing.
But it's not only the health implications that are being investigated.
These pollutants can also participate in climate processes, particularly in the formation of clouds and the reflection of solar radiation from particles. And so it's very important to properly understand what the processes are and how we may be changing the composition of the remote atmosphere of the Southern Hemisphere.
To help understand how air pollution can impact a city, CSIRO's Dr. Martin Copeny's team are conducting an intensive study into Sydney's air quality and modelling the implications for the future.
What we're interested in are very, very fine particles, so, you know, a tenth to a hundredth the size of a human hair. And they're so small, they basically just stick in the air like they're in treacle. And when you breathe them in, the particles will come all the way in with the airstream into your lungs, and there they can have health impacts.
Particles can come from man-made sources such as motor vehicles and industry, and from natural sources such as wind-blown dust and bushfire smoke. And there's secondary particles which are generated by the chemical reactions of some gaseous pollutants in the atmosphere.
They can come in all sorts of sizes. So as I was saying, you know, a tenth to a hundredth to a thousandth the size of a human hair. They can have different chemicals on them, which then can lead to different health effects. They can lead to scattering of the light, and they even have climate impacts as well.
To find out more about CSIRO's atmospheric research and to follow us on other social media, log on to www.csiro.au.